Magandang araw sa inyong lahat.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening po sa lahat ng nakikinig po.
Hello to all our viewers from here and around the world.
Napakaganda na ating talintayman ngayong hapon ito.
Isang mainit na pagbati po sa inyong lahat.
Well,
welcome to the Bridges Show. I'm very happy to be here. And I think it should be a really interesting and fun topic.
But there are things you want to learn. So I wanna take it from there and then I listen to them.
Mulungi silang mga mitiis upang maging makabuluhan pa ang pagiging Katoliko. Lalong-lalo na sa susunod na henerasyon.
Sa akin po, sa mga kabataan, ano, use confidence, no, as a basis.
In real life, hindi naman talaga tayo tumitigil sa buhay. Kailangan talaga, tuloy lang ang buhay kahit anong challenges natin.
Palawan, Cebu, Baguio City, Atty. Duarte, pati La Union. So we are saying that revenge, travel is real.
Mas kailangan natin na i-share ang hiwaga ng sinyo sa mga tao.
Food and health should go hand in hand. So yan ang gusto namin paratingin sa gobyerno.
If you will just devote your life to change, hindi ka yayaman sa pera, pero yayaman ka sa tao.
Siyempre, ang pinakamaganda po naman sa ating universidad ay yung talagang matuturuan po tayo kung paano maging mabuting tao.
Happy anniversary to Bridges! Here at Bridges, we build bridges of faith, bridges of hope, and bridges of love.
Every Filipino wants to own a house and a lot. Sino bang may ayaw na magkaroon ng sarili niyang property, di ba? Subdivisions, condominiums, and townhouses offer very good environment for safe, comfortable, and peaceful living. The increasing number of land developers is a good indicator that many investors have their eyes on real estate industry. This could indicate a bright future for diverse skilled workforce and for the economic growth of our community and our country. Believing in making wise decisions on real estate acquisition, Bridges present today's episode, This Land is Mine. This could indicate a bright future for all of us. So this is to understand more the world of the real estate industry, the state of land developing in the country, and to give us an idea of how we can best maximize our resources in acquiring real estate property. This is Dr. Evangeline E. Timba, the president of the College of Education Alumni Foundation Incorporated, also known as the CEFI. Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. This episode is brought to you by the UST Alumni Association Incorporated and the UST Graduate School Alumni Association. Before we continue, may I invite you to please remember to like and share our show and subscribe to our UST Tamasyan Alumni Community YouTube channel and follow our Facebook page. Joining me this afternoon is Mr. Jaime Campanero Lobos. Well, actually, he's a graduate of the Faculty of Sacred Theology in 2019. Okay, and he's been with the with this particular field of real estate since 2020. Okay, so with this, let's all welcome, of course, our co-host this afternoon, Mr. Jaime Campanero Lobos, to Bridges.
Hello, po.
Hello, how are you?
Dr. Benji, thank you for introducing me, no? And to all our witnesses, welcome, no? Welcome. And again, my name is Jaime Lobos Jr. and I'm an alumnus of UST, no? From the Faculty of Sacred Theology. So dati po akong seminarista. Mm-hmm. So dati akong seminarista. And again, I graduated 2019 and presently I am a licensed property specialist, no?
Wow.
And sabi nga kanina ni Dr. Vanji, I've been a realtor since 2020.
Mm-hmm.
So medyo matagal na din. I'm very, very much excited na lalong-lalo na sa topic ni Dr. O mamaya, no?
Yes. Okay. So alam mo, ang saya kong malaman, ikaw pala ay graduate ng Sacred Theology and now you are a very unique, highly interesting topic, no? Ang real estate industry. Okay, so in this kind of work that you are engaged now, how familiar are you kung pag-uusapan natin ngayon ang ating special guest?
Actually, kanina, Dr. Vanjie, no, nung nag-meeting pa lang tayo, nagpa-practice, sabi ko, excited na talaga ako. Sabi ko kasi nga, yung topic is very much close to my heart.
Yes,
no?
Yes.
Real estate, eh. Nung sinabi pa lang na real estate, gusto mong mag-host, sabi ko, sige, why not? Kasi nga, I'm very much excited. So, if not, siguro, na-encounter ko na siguro lahat. Kung hindi man lahat, siguro, no? Siguro na-encounter ko na yung karamihan ng mga questions. Lalong-lalo na when it comes to clients, and of course, sa mga appraisals, kung paano ba nag-pressure yung real estate. Ganun ako ka-excited. Kasi ano yung mga laws na kailangan. Yeah, oo, gusto ko. Na-excite kasi ako, Ma'am Vanjie. Oo, sobrang na-excite talaga ako. So,
yes, I guess you are starting to embrace a career that is, maybe I may say, hindi mo talaga inisip nung araw na magiging career mo, di ba?
Yeah, yes. That's true.
Yeah, and because of that, we have a very special guest who will tell us more about our topic on This Land Is Mine, Philippine Real Estate, a Lucrative Business. Ayan, ito ba ay lucrative pa talaga? Alamin natin yan. Would you like to introduce our guest today, Sir Jaime?
My pleasure, Ma'am Vanjie, no? So, let me introduce you. Our guest is none other than Dean Eduardo Ong, highly respected educator, real estate and management consultant, broker, appraiser, and social media influencer. He is a recipient of more than 500 awards and citation, prominently the Viral Award for Most Outstanding Realtor of the Year. Asia's Golden Icons Award for Asia's Most Outstanding Educator and Realtor of the Year 2022. 2020 Outstanding Professional in Real Estate Services from the College, from Outstanding Alumnus of the University of Santo Tomas, Graduate School and College of Commerce, Outstanding Citizen of Malabon, Outstanding Father of the Year and Realtor of the Year, Outstanding Men of Influence with the late President Fidel V. Ramos. He holds a Diplomate in Business Education, Fellow in People Management, Diplomate in Real Estate Management, and Outstanding Star Teacher Award given by the Consortium of the South Association of the Colleges and Universities in the South of Metro Manila. Dr. Ong has written and published 6 books in real estate management: economics, research, methodology, marketing, management, sociology, and Asian civilization. Presently, Dr. Ong is the Dean of College of Real Estate Management of Lyceum of Alabang. He is also an international realtor of the National Association of Realtors USA and a certified international property specialist. And international real estate consultant based in Paris, France. Dr. Ong is a Vice President for Education and Training of FIABCI World, an international federation of real estate professionals in 49 countries. Moreover, he occupied prestigious positions in various real estate and business organizations. To name a few, former National President of Philippine Association of Real Estate Board Incorporated. And at present, currently Vice President of UST Graduate School, Alumni and Grants Association Incorporated, and a Treasurer, Director of Philippine Dispute Resolution Center Incorporated, Chairman for Education of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Chairman of the Philippine Federation of the Real Estate Services Professional Incorporated, among others. Friends, of course, let us welcome our multi-awarded summation guest, Dr. Eduardo G. Ong.
Thank you.
Welcome po, Dr. Ong.
Eh, thank you, Jimmy. Shall I call you Jimmy? Okay, Jimmy, yeah, and my very good friend, Dr. Vanjie.
Now, Dr. Ong, welcome to our show, Dr. E.G. Grabe, wala na akong masabi.
It is indeed a pleasure and an honor for me to be invited here in your highly acclaimed Bridges.
Yes, the Bridges. So, Dr. Ong, ano pa masasabi ko? Outstanding father, outstanding citizen, outstanding alumnus, outstanding businessman. Ano ba ang iba pang outstanding na hindi mo nakukuha? You got
always standing.
Nakatuwa, no? So, thank you for finding time to be with us this afternoon.
Siyempre, yeah, basta yung
SU. Kung kami marami kang commitment, ikaw pa, Diyos ko, ang dami kang commitment. Napakadami mga real estate developments ba ang nangyayari ngayon? So, we'll be updated later, no? Tell us, Dean, what is the status of real estate in the Philippines today?
Okay.
Are you going to show us some slides?
Pwede na ba ka mag-present ng slide?
It's okay. Yeah. If you want to start with the profile of the Philippine real estate industry.
Okay. Hello. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Hello, Russians and friends. Let me tell you the projected growth of the Philippine real estate industry.
Okay.
In 2022, the industry registered the 7.6 GDP growth, one of the highest in the world.
Really?
In 2023, the Philippine economy back on track to pre-pandemic level. Because I remember in 2020, that's supposed to be March, mm-hmm. we were all incarcerated in our own homes. And the prices of goods and commodities has risen up, skyrocketed high, no? I remember I was buying a tap-tap cord.
Mm-hmm.
I had to order from Cavite and the price was triple. My goodness. But, you know, after the pandemic, we saw the light at the end of the tunnel in 2023. 2020 ang pandemic, 2020, 2021. But in 2022, we went back on track and registered a 7.6 GDP growth of the Philippines, no? One of the highest in the whole world. In 2023, the Philippine economy back on track to pre-pandemic level. Bumalik na tayo ng 2023. In 2025, it is projected that the Philippine internet economy will be US dollars 40 billion, 5.3% of the Philippine GDP. Now we can see the entry and the proliferation of artificial intelligence. And most of our students now, starting from the elementary, from the basic education up there in the collegiate level, are now exposed on the internet. Just like, not like us, diba, Doc Banji, during our time, we were, what, the typewriter economy and now in 2030, it is also projected that the economy will grow to 1 trillion with a population of 128 million. In 2050, it is projected that the Philippines will be the 19th largest economy in the world.
I have a question.
Yes.
You mentioned 2022. There was one registry of one of the highest in the world, growth
in
the Philippines. Pero nagkaroon tayo ng pandemic noong 2020 and 21. Bakit ganun kabilis tayo nakabalik sa century of growth?
Because of very strong fundamentals.
Uh-huh.
Ating, very strong economic fundamentals. Mm-hmm. Kaya yung ating GDP growth move up.
Oh.
And I think it was during the time of a former President Duterte, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So, naka-pull swing yan, development of infrastructure, development of all of these, and downside, talagang ang development umakyat. So, that's why in 2023 and of course now 2024, talagang kuha na tayo. Actually, in the real estate industry, talaga namang hindi nag-umpisa, talaga namang punong-puno. We are all loaded with a lot of inquiries, a lot of, not only from the Philippines, but also from abroad.
Mm-hmm.
So I have said kanina, a while ago, I was talking to a client in New Jersey. Sabi niya, hindi pa naman ako natutulog eh. Pwede ba, bilhin ko na yung property sa Tagaytay? You know, these are all areas that are on the bright side. Alam mo ba, despite the volcano eruption, despite all of these setbacks, ang Pilipinas talagang favorite haven, especially those that are, you know, remember that we have the longest beaches in the world, ha? Ang namang all over tayo, surrounded by water. And some are all white sand. Kaya nga, we see the development there. Now, noong araw, we want to look at Boracay as the top or the number one, no, destination of tourists. But now, ngayon nakita natin, hindi na Boracay maakyat na sa tatlong level. From Boracay, it now goes to El Nido in Coron, no? And meron pang isang development that would happen, and that is in Oriental Mindoro in Bulalacao. Kaya ngayon, those investors who would want to buy properties there, this is the right time to buy. Kung mahilig kayo sa sea, mahilig kayo sa, you know, all of these things, then you need to really invest in this area. You know, would you believe it? In 3 years ago, I bought a property in Bulalacao which cost only about 100,000 per hectare. Imagine 10,000 square meters yan. Kaya ngayon ata, nasa doble na. And tataas pa ng tataas yan. But because of the, because Filipinos are very good eh. They can easily adapt. Kaya yung ating internet economy now. Before, in real estate marketing, alam ko yan ni Jimmy, no? In real estate marketing, you have to go face to face. Ngayon, yes, a real estate demonstration and presentation of the property can be done virtually. Alam mo ba? Kaya lang, ang, of course, ang closing and the negotiation and closing of the transactions will have to be done on a face-to-face basis. Kasi andyan na yung tawaran eh. Andyan na yung...
Yeah.
Pero pag yung pakita mo pala yung property, pwede ng online, pwede ng virtual.
Ito ka, Angie, you mentioned about investors. So, would you have an idea now at this point how many percent are foreign investors? Are they really allowed?
Well, the latest statistics last year was that there was an influx of foreign investors basically coming from China, from South Korea, from Japan, and some not a sizable amount from the US and also from the European nations, no? Kaya ganyan ang on natin.
So paano sila nakapag-invest kung sila ay foreigners? Are they allowed to buy land?
In the Philippines, you know, you cannot, it is in our constitution that only Filipinos can own land. However, yeah. What do they do? They form corporation which is 60% Filipino, 40% foreign. Yun mga corporation na yun, yan ang mga bumibili. Another thing is that, you know, punta ka sa Boracay, go to these beaches, no? You can see a lot, they are owned by foreigners, pero sabi mo, paano silang makakabili ng property? They do it around, we say they married a Filipina, and who can acquire property, or meron silang mga girlfriend na yung title ng property sa kanila nila inilalagay. But basically, sila ang may-ari noong nung property wherein they put mga a lot of things, no, a lot of actually yung mga business establishment doon nilalagay. You can see that in Boracay, and also you can see that in El Nido in Coron, Palawan, no? Maraming yan. Kaya I'm saying that Banji, right now really is the time to invest in real estate in these areas. Oh. But later on, I'll be discussing with you in the area. Kasi per area, no? When
yes,
you look
yes.
at beaches, ayan, tatlong area na yan. When you look at development, we have Metro Manila, we have Calabarzon area, we have naman in the North Quadrangle, no, that's the Clark, Subic area, up there in Baguio. And even in La Union, it's now developing. And after in Ilocos, movement of real estate program. With the completion of the ELEC, ESITEC, TIPILEC, alam niyo 'yon, 'di ba? ELEC, mapuntang Baguio, now travel to Baguio now used to be from 7 hours, it's now reduced to about 3.5 or 4 hours. Kasi dire-diretso ka na lang eh. Dati, almost a day ang biyahe mo sa Baguio. But today, hindi na. No? Okay. So, meron pa? Can I move on?
Yes.
Sandali ah. Sandali.
Go ahead po.
Okay.
Interesting, no, Jaime?
Yeah. Kaya nakatutok ako kay Dr. Ong lang eh.
Marami kang natututunan.
Yeah.
Kailan, yung nung bang before the pandemic noong 2019 and backwards, ganun din ba ang trend ng the growth ng real estate industry sa Philippines? Parang ngayon lang nagpo-flourish talaga eh, no? Parang may nagawang maganda rin ang pandemic, no? Parang maganda, gumanda ang value ng ating mga properties.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Ayan, meron ipipresent si Dr. Eugene na susunod na slide niya. Okay.
Okay.
Ayan. Recovery.
Okay, continue. On a year-to-year growth rates, no? Quarter 4 and full year 2022 in present, we have a GDP of, you know, GNI, gross national income of 9.3%, 9.9%. Then GDP, gross domestic product of 7.2%. And 7.6, and NPI net primary income of 5 to 7.5% to 76.5%. So yung blue is quarter four. Yung full year is yung green. Yung medyo green is no 2022. Now you see that the GDP rate biglang bumagsak nung 2020. Nakita yon, bagsak siya oh. Then, in 2020, umaakyat na siya unti-unti until in 2021, medyo gumanda talaga na, 12.1. And then down the line, medyo nag-taper off na in 2022. So, okay. Okay, what could be the reason why booming Philippine economy? GDP growth shoot up to 7.6% in 2020 and projected to remain robust around 6% in 2023 and 2024. There is a surging housing demand and high rental yield. Kaya lamang nalulungkot ako kasi yung rental, alam mo, ang nag-dominate ng rental natin during last year. In the last 2 years was the legitimate POGO. O, diba? Yung Philippine offshore gaming, no? But ngayon, alam naman natin what's happening now in our needs, in our environment, the society natin medyo, I think there was a move from some legislators to ban POGO. Pero in 2022, nag-propel ng growth natin, and 2020, yung POGO because of the high rental yield. I do not know. We're trying to project in 2024 because of the present scenario, what's happening today, medyo nag-taper off. Growing demand for foreign investors. The Philippines offers significantly higher rental yields, particularly in select prime areas. Let me tell you the economic zones. No? Meron tayong PESA, the Philippine Economic Zone, and economic zones all over in Cebu and all over in Mindanao. Marami po yan because investors can locate in that area. Infrastructure development. And that is one of the greatest legacy of, I think, President Duterte, which started during the time of President Aquino, which is now being followed and completed by President Bongbong Marcos. The Philippines is experiencing a boom in the infrastructure development, fueled by strong economy, government initiatives, and rising investors' interest. Okay. Let's look at the real estate market. The average property prices in Asia, in the whole of Asia, is $28,570 in Hong Kong, in Japan, you can see in Singapore, in China, India, Taiwan, Thailand, Philippines, $3,952. In Malaysia, Cambodia, Indonesia, and Vietnam. Kita nyo naman, medyo competitive sa Pilipinas. In average rental yield in Asia is, let's look at the Philippines, no? The Philippines, we are number 2, 6.13. Ibig sabihin, ang ganda-ganda ng investment natin, ng ating rental sa Pilipinas. Yung average price of a change in Asia, you can see the Philippines is number 3, no? 96.99. Talagang nagiging investment hub ng Pilipinas. Okay. Now, looking at, let's give you some statistics, no, for the benefit of our listeners, our viewers. The Philippines is an archipelagic country, no, surrounded by sea of 7,107 islands. Sabi nga nila, jokingly, high tide. Pero pag low tide, inaabot ng 7,400 islands, no? But covering, would you believe it? We have 300,000 square kilometers or equivalent to about 30 million hectares. And 298,170 square kilometers of land. Ha? 298 ang ating square kilometers of land. Ibig sabihin noon, land and forest. And 1,830 square kilometers of water. So, mas malaki talaga ang lupa kesa sa dagat. But yung dagat natin all over are one of the favorite fishing ground of so many countries. That's why we have dispute all over. And the infrastructure, as you can see over there, kita naman natin, no? Meron tayong Skyway ngayon, which lessened the trip from south to north, from the South Luzon Expressway to the North Luzon, to the North Luzon Expressway, from used to be 2.5 hours, now it can be reduced to less than 1 hour because of the Skyway. And now, all over the Philippines, meron tayong Ro-Ro, di ba? That you can reach by gusto yan ang gusto ko subukan eh Ro-Ro to from the Philippines from Luzon to Mindanao by via Ro-Ro. And what is most important now, very important development sa Pilipinas, we will have in Metro Manila, we will have the first subway in Metro Manila. And well, fueled by our transportation hub, no? Well, alam mo naman tayo, marami tayong P2P o point-to-point, merong Express, UB Express, meron tayong Maangkas, meron tayong Grab. We used to have Uber, pero na-taken over ata ng Grab. A lot of tricycles, jeepneys, and of course, taxis, and LRT, MRT, all over. No? Kaya, kan tayo. We are lucky. All right. Nang yung ating main station going up to would be kasi actually ang all over sa atin eh yung EDSA top station dinidevelop na yan ngayon eh. And then yung MRT1 is also on the way. Meron tayong subway starting in Ortigas, no? Okay, so more or less in a nutshell, this is the development. But if I am given a lot more time, I can give you the precise development piece by piece all over Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao. But let me just focus on some development in Metro Manila. Prices of land in Metro Manila is really skyrocketing high. In BGC area, the Bonifacio Global City, would you believe it, that the price of property reaches up to 1 million per square meter. Noong araw, it's only Ayala Avenue na nag 800 to 900,000 per square meter. Ngayon, natalo na ng BGC. In the area of the Bay Area, like the MOA area and the Asiana area, no, ang presyo doon, 400 to 500,000 per square meter. And remember, alam mo, reclaim land yan, ha? And ang taas pa rin ang presyo. And development now is from the south, the Calabarzon area, from the north, the north quadrangle, no, from the Clark, and then the Clark area and the Subic area, and from the east now is developing from Pasig, nagkaroon ata si Jimmy, no, Pasig downline to Cainta, then to Taytay, then to Binangonan, to Antipolo, to Tanay, up there in Quezon province. Yan, in a nutshell, yan ang development. Okay.
Dr. G, very interesting ang updates, di ba?
Yeah.
But let me also tell you that you cannot just sell real estate in the Philippines today. Before you are allowed to sell real estate in the Philippines, you have to be licensed now by the Professional Regulation Commission. We used to have our license because I was licensed in 1987. Bata-bata pa ako noon. And we were under the Bureau of Trade Regulation and Consumer Protection of the Department of Trade and Industry. At that time, we were considered only a skill, ahente ka, ahente lang. But in because of the RESA law or the Real Estate Service Act of the Philippines, Republic Act 9646, from being a skilled or job, we are now promoted to become a real estate professional because of the law, which was signed into law by President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo on June 29, 2009. And was effectively implemented in 2010. So yung RESA law, 12 years na o 13 years na. And covers 5 categories. Salesperson, yung sinasabi ko nga si Jimmy, a property specialist, kailangan mag-register na yan. Yung salesperson, and then to be a broker, and then up then to be an appraiser, and then assessor of government are now included in RESA law. Pag ikaw ay city assessor, municipal assessor, you have to be licensed. And the apex of the career in real estate is that of being a real estate consultant. Kaya nga po yung aming, but how many are the consultants today? I have licensed about 600 consultants only. Why? Because before you can be a consultant, you should have been a broker for 10 years or you should have been an appraiser for 5 years before you can take or allowed to take the licensure examination or given by the Professional Regulation Commission. But mind you, sabi ko nga kay Jimmy that today you can no longer take the examination if you cannot produce to the satisfaction of PRC a degree in real estate management. Kaya nga ngayon, tabong-tabo ngayon ang BS Real Estate Management. Napakadaming gustong mag-real estate. Kaya now, I have estimated that we have now a license, a total of about 80,000 licensed and accredited brokers and salesperson. But I tell you, there are over 200,000 selling properties in the whole of Philippines without the benefit of licensing. They should worry because the PRC recently inked an agreement with the police, with the CIDG, with the Philippine National Police, with the Armed Forces of the Philippines, and with the LGU to ferret out the pernicious practices of unlicensed real estate practitioners. Kaya yan ang sinasabi ko. And I'm telling Jimmy, license. Okay.
Yeah. And Dr. Ong, question. Kasi actually maraming nanonood, no? Lalong-lalo na yung mga kawork ko.
Oh, yes.
They've been asking, to clarify lang siguro yung sinabi nyo na about license, pagpakaroon ng license, no? Does it mean, for example, now, kasi yearly yung pag-ano namin, pag-update namin eh, sa PRC and of course sa DSHUD or DSHUD, nag-update kami doon yearly. So, does it
so
mean
you are an accredited salesperson?
Yeah.
Nag-attend ba kayo ng seminar? So, salesperson, yes, yes. But you're under a broker.
Yes po. Opo.
Oh, under a broker. Yun ang first level. Yun ang entry level.
So no need for ano, hindi na kami need na mag-exam doon, right? Pwede na 'yun.
Wala exam ang entry level kasi seminar lang 'yon na 12 yeah. hours, no? 'Di ba? 12 mm-hmm. hours of seminar and renewal 5 hours. Tama?
Opo. So pwede na kaming magbenta doon kahit 'yun lang, tama?
You cannot sell without a broker.
Ayan,
you have to have a broker with you. So you should be shepherded by the broker.
Mm-mm. So kailangan andun pa rin si broker, no? To guide us kapag nagbebenta kami, tama?
Yes, yes, yes. Kasi actually, yan ang problema ngayon eh. In the giving of commissions, yung mga developers, marami silang sellers, no? Maraming mga ahente. Yung mga salesperson nila, normally dapat should have a broker. And the commission must be given to the broker, and the broker should give it to the salesperson. But what's happening now is that the developers give the commission straight to the seller, straight to the salesperson, salespeople.
Yeah.
Naiiwanan yung broker, kaya nagre-reklamo yung broker. Sabi nila, aba, eh, hindi naman sila nakuha na exam, bakit sila ganun, ganun, ganito. And that is one error, one flaw that PRC is trying to correct. Kaya maraming issue ngayon, na especially recently nag-issue ang Board of Real Estate Service where I used to be the chairman of the Board of Real Estate for 8 years, no? Nag-issue ng memorandum sinasabi na you cannot sell without an authority. So you cannot sell without an authority to sell issued by the seller or by the owner of the property. Ganun.
Thank you so much. And also, just to follow up na, Dr. Ong, since may time pa naman tayo, you mentioned about the sanctions. Kasi ako, personally, hindi ko naman i-deny yun. May nakilala ako for the past years na late na nagkaroon ng lisensya. May mga ganun eh, nadidelay kasi pinaprocess pa nila or kakilala ng broker, tapos minsan nagbebenta na sila. So ano yung mga sanctions kaya doon?
Okay, the penalty clause of RESA law is if you are licensed, you are accredited, you know, you a penalty of 100,000 pesos or 2 years imprisonment or both, depending upon the discretion of the judge. Ngayon, kung unlicensed ka, ikaw hindi ka considered accredited ka, no? Halimbawa, hindi mo nagbenta, wala siyang lisensya, double penalty. 200,000 pesos penalty plus 4 years imprisonment or both upon the discretion of the court.
Okay. So sa mga nanonood dyan, lalong-lalo na yung mga katrabaho ko dati, ha? Lisensya.
Okay, so nakita natin yung broker at saka yung salesman relationship, no? Dr. EJ, kung saan man yung appraiser at saka assessor?
Okay. Ang ang assessor is a different actually, tinatanong ko nga ang legislature, eh. Bakit nasama pa ang assessor dito? Samantalang assessor can only do appraisal for taxation purposes only.
Oh.
Hindi sila pwede magbenta. Taxation purposes lang sila. Pero ang appraiser, private appraiser, you know, we have about 10,000 appraisers, licensed appraisers in the Philippines. 5,000 of which, or a little bit over 5,000, are private appraisers. Ibig sabihin, nag-appraise. Pero yung mga 5,000 or a little bit less are assessors that you can see in the local government units, and they are supervised by the BLGF or the Bureau of Local Finance, which is housed in the Central Bank. Local Government Finance, BLGF.
Okay, and dami palang level, no, ng umabot bago maging isang consultant. So, being a real estate consultant, so would you like to share to those who are not getting interested to get into this job, ano yung mga qualifications or personal traits?
Yeah. Okay, if you are, umpisahan natin, Doc Banji, sa lower level, no?
Okay.
Lower, lowest level is that of a sales, tawag namin doon, salesperson.
Salesperson.
A salesperson do not have or do not need to take the examination.
Okay.
But they are required to take, to undergo a 12 hours of real estate training. Ang tawag namin doon, RSTP, Real Estate Salesperson Training Program. 12 okay. hours accredited by a legitimate provider like me so that you can use it in your application as a salesperson with PRC under, I would like to emphasize, no, under a legitimate and licensed real estate broker. Kung wala kang broker, hindi ka namin tatanggapin.
Okay. So,
but you know, I was installed. Well, I was appointed by President GMA in March 2, actually to be exact, in 2010. Kasi ang ating batas eh 2009 pa, pero 2010 kami na approve. Ibig sabihin wala DTI pa yon. And in 2010, we were not able to function. Lima kami members of the board. Mm-hmm. Yung five members of the board, and I was the chairman, actually. You know, and mayroon akong apat, two from government assessors, mm-hmm. and two from private. Tsaka ako, private ako. Dito, 3-2, no, pagdating ng ganon. Pero hindi kami makapag-implement right away because we were considered midnight appointees of GMA.
Mm-hmm.
Eh, March 10, di ba? March 10, may appointment ba na? Hindi na pwede mag-appoint. So when President Pinoy took the helm of leadership in Malacanang, all of the PRC appointees were reappointed. Ayan, that was the time that we started to roll our sleeves and do the professionalization of the industry. That's why July na yon. Kasi si Pinoy, July na yan nag-umpisa, no? June 30 siya na nag-swear in. So July 1st na reappointed lahat ng PRC appointees. And that's why, ito Jimmy, no, maybe you don't know that July is very important month for us. July is called the RESA Awareness Month. Yan.
Regulations.
We're still in the month. Within the month.
RESA Awareness Month.
How about Dr. AG, meron din ba nagiging mga issues, problems, or disputes na we have to understand and we have to be ready with and we have to solve?
The most, the problem that are encountered mostly, I'm talking of during my term for 8 years as PRC chairman for real estate, the common problems I encountered are the not paying o onsihan sa komisyon. Hindi nagpabayad ng komisyon o hindi nakakakuha ng tamang komisyon o walang komisyon. Something like that. So how do you do that? How do you solve that problem? It will have to go back into the authority. Walang problema if you are into project selling, no? Because if you are in project selling, eh, ahente ka ng developer. So naturally, the developer naman will pay you. But you just don't know when. It has to be spelled out in your contract. Mm-hmm. However, if you do real estate brokerage, alam ni Jimmy yan, real estate brokerage, yung talagang yung owner ng property, pinabebenta sa yung property niya. What is most important is you should get an authority to sell from the owner of the property. Otherwise, maraming pitfalls dyan. Maraming problemang lumalabas dyan na nauuwi sa hindi pagbibigay ng komisyon at nauuwi sa demandahan, nauuwi sa legal suits, or even sometimes in my tenure, I saw bodily harm. Mm-hmm. Oh, ganun eh. Pera yan eh. Commission yan eh. Pag hindi ka nabigyan, eh, di sama ng loob mo. Mm-hmm. Kaya I always joke my constituency during my time. Sabi ko, ay, ang problema natin talaga ay commission. Pero yeah, ako, sa board, pag dinala nyo sa akin ang problema, maraming consumisyon.
yan po, Dr. EG, yung problema dun sa relationship ng, let's say, broker or your salesperson. Ano yung mga problems na encounter nyo sa mga investor in terms of yung mga leasing arrangement, financing arrangement?
We are now doing caravans, no?
Mm-hmm.
Because there are so many associations in the real estate industry, and some of them are really doing networking all over the Philippines, all over the world. As a matter of fact, I'm flying to Bangkok again in August to speak and to network with our fellow ASEAN partners in real estate. Kasi iba-iba naman ang batas ng real estate sa iba-ibang parte ng mundo. But in Asia, magandang market sa Asia.
No? Mm-hmm.
And likewise, ang problema talagang nakikita ko dyan sa real estate is you have to look at the legal documentation.
Okay.
Kasi napaka konting tuwang lang sa konting error that you can see in the documents, patay ka na.
Mm.
Like when you buy a property, are you entering into a deed of sale or entering into a contract to sell?
Mm.
Oh, when you do a contract to sell, do you do reservation? How much you pay? Normally kasi because of the very tight competition, a buyer who's buying property from a developer, they do sign, di ba, down payment 20%. Eh, walang pandown yung OFW. So, ang ginagawa ng developer, they allow the OFW to amortize the 20%.
Mm-hmm.
Di ba? Halimbawa, 10 million, o 5 million na lang ang property. Yung 20% noon, dapat ibayad mo.
Mm-hmm.
So, yung, eh, walang pambayad, pinakamababa, you know, I can see in the market, they require siguro mga 20,000, 25,000, and as high as 50,000 initial down payment to mm-hmm. get the property. O, edi okay na, no? Sa'yo na yung property. Ngayon, mababayaran mo ba? That is the question.
Yeah, yung balance.
Mababayaran mo yung balance, eh. And the caveat there is you are only issued a what we call contract to sell, na hindi naman sigurado na mapupunta sa yung property.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, in 100% transaction, 20% down payment, upon full payment of the down payment, the broker is already entitled to the commission. Ha? Tanda mo yung 20% down payment, may commission ka na. What happened to the 80%? Mm-hmm. The 80% is financed by SSS, Pag-ibig, GSIS, yeah, and even our local banks. Kaya marami pa rin tinataanan. Ano, Jimmy?
Or in-house financing, right?
Or in-house financing developer, kung maraming pera, pinipinance nila. Pero normally, hindi. Ang pinipinance, yeah, in-house financing, down payment lang.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Down payment lang ang pinipinance nila.
Dr. Ong, are you familiar with, kasi may nag-ask din sa akin, now, are you familiar with the Maseda law? Since you mentioned about paying Stagard, no?
That's buyer's protection.
Yeah. Can you share about it kahit short lang? Kasi para at least aware lang din yung mga sellers.
Okay. Para, we put it in a very simple explanation. Under the Maseda law, the buyer is protected. No? Buyer's protection. Kaya ang mga broker should look into how it is implemented. Pag nagbayad ka na ng down payment, now you are now covered by the law. And may mga sometimes forfeiture na nangyayari, di ba?
Yes,
you're not able to pay this, mapoforfeit ka. You cannot just do that. It has to be spelled out in a contract that you sign. Under the Maseda law, you are completely protected by the law. Pero unless you sign a document that is not within the ambit of the law, eh sa'yo na yon, and that you can look into that. Yung PD 957 also is also important. Pero ngayon kasi nasa disood na tayo eh. If yeah. you are selling projects, you are not only going to register with PRC. After getting your accreditation from PRC under a broker, you have to go to disood to register, and you have to get a number of the disood number. And ano requirement ng disood? Requirement ng disood is you have to give a 5,000 surety bond. Sa PRC naman, if you are a broker, you have to give a 20,000 surety bond or cash bond. Para saan yun? It is in the law to answer for whatever infractions you're going to commit. Pero maliit yun?
Yeah, oo. Compared naman sa income siguro, no? Yung iba lang talaga is tamad. Tamad lang umuha.
But you know, you can never, sabi nga ni late President Franklin Delano Roosevelt, it is the safest investment in the whole world. Because it cannot be taken away from you. Lupa yun eh.
Apo. Tama. Sir, Dr. Ed, would you be willing to share to our viewers ano pa na magkaroon na ng further interest to go into real estate industry if they want to work, no? Work. Ano ba ang mga incentives?
Okay, this is the benefits of going into real estate. Number one, you can have an unlimited income.
Wow.
It really depends on your work, hard work.
Mm-hmm.
Because you can sign your own paycheck. Mm-hmm. In other words, kung how hard you work, how hard the money comes to you.
Mm-hmm.
Dating ang pera sa'yo if you are good in selling. And mm-hmm. how can you be good in selling? Attend mga seminars or training or development ng ibang mga, should I say, yung mga kilala o yung mga proven leaders in the industry. Marami pong ganyan. And thirdly, alam mo ba, you have the money, then you can travel abroad. And you can have your own houses and lots, your own condo, your own cars, beautiful cars, and things like that. And at the same time, it is important that you can succeed in real estate. You do a lot of meeting people. Network. Yes. When I accept invitations to speak abroad, the honorarium is not much naman. But what I counted most is the network that I can establish and the people that I will meet, which can be my future, client.
Yes.
Like about last month, I was in Vietnam, in Ho Chi Minh. Mm-hmm. I met the officers of the Vietnam Real Estate Association.
Mm-hmm.
So we agreed to sign a MOA to assist Vietnamese people who would want to invest in the Philippines through my organization, through my company, so I can help them and we can share commissions.
Mm-hmm.
Tatanong ni Jimmy, paano ba ang commission ng mga foreigner?
Yeah.
Because tatanong ni Jimmy, under the law, normally when you go abroad, ang commission natin is in the Philippines. Diba? Now how can you share it? Ibibigay mo ba ang kalahati ng commission mo sa foreigner? Hindi. What you do is what we fondly call referral fee.
Oh.
Referral is normally 10-20% of your total commission that you get from the transaction.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Very clear.
Yes, okay. So, ang ganda pala talaga, no? Kahit ano, may mga percentage pa din pala silang marireceive doon. Which is totoo naman. Kasi pag may referral, at least hindi mo na trabaho din lahat, no?
There was a property I sold before the pandemic in Bangkok, Thailand. it is called the Orange Country, the Orange Village, no, in Pattaya. If you have been to Bangkok, Pattaya is a very famous tourist place, no? And sila lahat nag-asikaso, ako lang nag-refer nung client. Yeah. Sila nag-asikaso, registration and everything else. What do I get? Referral fee. Which can be in baht, in Thailand baht, or in US dollars. Siyempre, ganun. No?
So, pwede tayong Jaime, ganun. Mag-refer tayo.
Yeah. Actually, wala talaga eh. Kumbaga, pag-referral, I mean, you're lucky, no? Kaya kailangan talaga, sabi nga ni Dr. Ong kanina, kailangan marami kang network, no? Marami kang network, marami kang kakilala, kasi sila din yung magbebenta or magre-refer ng isang property sa'yo. At malaking tulong na yun, kasi hindi na yun trabaho eh. Hindi mo na yung tatrabaho yun.
Remember that a highly satisfied client would refer you and refer you to other classes. That was a very good example that I am using in my life. No, well, an example, no, there was a director of the Department of Trade and Industry na nagtanong sa akin. They said, EG, I want to buy a house, a lot, or the least I want to buy a lot in BF Homes. Okay, teritoryo ko yun eh, no? So, nabigyan ko siya ng property, sinerp ko siya, ng, hanggang sa nagpatayo siya ng bahay, kumuha kami ng contractor and everything else. So, in other words, the couple was so happy about my services.
Mm-mm.
And during occasions, tandaan nyo to, before pa di pandemic, birthday, padala ka ng card. Buti pa nga, nung araw kami, magastos. Padala ka ng card, padala ka ng cake. Pero ngayon, text-text na lang. Eh. Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Pwede na. But at that time, and what was really wonderful was yung nung binenta ko yung property, yung anak niya, dalawang babae, maliliit pa, siguro mga 10 years old pa lamang, and things like that, no? So, ngayon, surprisingly, itong 2022, tumawag sa akin. Sabi niya, G, hanap po nga ako ng property dito, sa malapit dito sa bahay ko. Bakit? Kasi mag-aasawa na yung panganay ko, and I want to give her a house and lot. Wow. Itulungan mo naman ako. O, sino ngayon? O, nang gagawa nun? Di ikaw, uli. Happy kasi siya sa services mo. Kaya ikaw pa rin ang gagawa at ikaw pa rin ang mangungumisyon. Ang diba?
Value for the service. Yes naman.
For the service.
Yes. Naku, Sir Jaime, ano ba yan?
Yeah.
Ano pala? We're almost at the end of our discussion.
Actually,
parang ilang oras, ano?
Hindi ko napansin. Hindi ko rin napansin kasi nag-i-enjoy din ako kakapakinig tsaka katanong kay Dr. Ong. No?
Yes. Okay. Salamat, again, Jimmy. Now, Jimmy is now my network.
Yeah. And of course, you, Dr. Ong, you are my network also.
I have a lot of properties. Properties all over the Philippines. No, yun, man, in Cebu, Davao, Cagayan de Oro, Baguio, lahat. And I have one thing good. Last week, I went to Tagaytay. I'm going back this weekend because I've got a lot of good properties in Tagaytay. Condominium. Wow. And also vacant lots, farm lots, going up there, Tagaytay, down to Batangas. Maraming property doon. If your client needs property there, let me know and I'm going to give you referral.
Invite
talaga. Grabe, nakaka-hype, no? Nakaka-hype. But again, Dr. Ong, as much as we want to patagalin pa to, no? Patagalin pa sana. And of course, sabi nga, marami kaming natutunan, lalong-lalo na yung mga viewers. And of course, yung mga kakilala ko na nanonood ngayon, yung mga co-agents ko. And sa lahat, no, na Tomasians na nanonood. And of course, thank you so much, no? Thank you very much, Dr. Ong. This has been a very interesting learning session. Sobra, no? Sobra. And the time went so fast, hindi namin talaga napansin. And sobrang dami naman ng ano ang napag-usapan natin from the moment, no, nung sisimula kung ano yung GDP, kung saan tayo tumaas masyado, yung pagbebenta ng properties and hanggang sa mga laws, no? Ano yung mga kailangang sundin ng mga agents, kung yung mga gustong mag-agent. And ngayon, ano yung perks, no? Ano yung perks ng pagiging realtor or broker? And nasabi mo yun lahat. Of course, for me, what I like the most is yung time freedom, no? Time freedom. Kasi pag nasa real estate ka talaga,
You own the time.
Ikaw na yung papasok kung kailan mo gusto, and ikaw yung mag-schedule sa mga clients mo, yung mga ganun. And of course, financial freedom, which is makakatulong ka pa sa mga pamilya mo and others. No?
Pero ang importante ang importante dito, sipag at tiyaga, at saka focus ka.
Yeah.
Ibenta ko, yun ang ibenta ko.
Correct, correct. So your presence, yes.
And I would like, Doc Banji, I would like to thank you for this opportunity.
Yes.
And also, I would like to invite my fellow Tomasians who would want to go into the real estate business to contact us, contact Jimmy, and contact me, so we can do it together. So you can earn a lot of bucks, lot of money in real estate.
Yes. So, Dr.
Actually, mamaya ako kukontakin ko kagad si Dr. Rong
Kontakin mo na after din si sigurado yun, you're in good hands.
Mamaya after ng session natin to, no, katawag ko kagad, Dr. Rong, may pwede ba tayong ibenta dyan?
Oh yeah, sure. Marami akong listing all over the Philippines.
So, Dr. EG, may last question tayo. What Tomasian values are working best for you in this kind of work that you are engaged at?
I have been a Tomasian for the longest time. I earned my bachelor's degree from UST, my master's degree from UST, my PhD from UST, and all the years of my life, I am a Tomasian. And maybe people don't know that during my college days, I worked in the accounting department of UST. So I worked my ass through college. No, I was then under the Dominican priest, you know, and that was a very good training that I got, and I will always be a Tomasian for life. And I say that the commitment, the passion, the dedication to serve our fellow men, the best service that we can do is the hallmark of a true Tomasian. With the graces of God, we'll all be successful in our real estate endeavor.
Ayan. Sir Jaime.
Totoo yun. Dr. Ong, no, syempre as Tomasian, as lalo-lalo na, nag-graduate ako from the Faculty of Sacred Theology, no, sobrang laking tulong, no, yung naging background ko sa naging profession ko ngayon, no. Sobrang daming mga challenges, and yet, we rise up, no. We rise up pa din, despite the challenges. And with that, Dr. Ong, may final message ka ba sa mga viewers natin?
I say that should I call you Brother Jimmy? Brother Jimmy? You have a lot of potentials, no? That I think, the way I look at you, I think you can really succeed in real estate. And you are welcome to join my team.
Yeah, tatawag na ako mamaya.
Professional. And also, Doc Banji, long time friend. God.
Pwede pa ba ako?
Doc Banji, we spent so many sleepless nights when we were organizing the UST grant. UST alumni grant association. You know, Doc Banji and myself, we were incorporators, no? Of the association dedicated for the UST grad school.
Yes,
and just like a true Tomasian, true-blooded Tomasian, full-blooded Tomasian, we'll be helping each other. And to my brother Tomasian, tawag lang po kayo, and we'll be here as Tomasian to help you. We'll all make you, should I say, rich?
Okay, so maraming salamat po, Dr. Eduardo G. Ong. Nakakatuwa, siklidlig at umaapaw ang kaalaman natin ngayong hapon. Napaganda po na ating talakayan at kwentuhan. It was so engaging and so enlightening. We wish to thank, by the way, our sponsors, the UST Graduate School Alumni Foundation Incorporated, and the UST Alumni Association. Maraming maraming salamat po. Before we finally close the show, we would like to congratulate the College of Education for being proclaimed the top one in teacher education, both in elementary and secondary education.
Wow, congratulations, no, College of Education. And also Mashan teachers, no, congratulations. We should also like to thank all our alumni, students, and friends who have faithfully watched, salamat, salamat, shared and liked our Bridges episodes. We share with you the blessings of Bridges and do continue to stay with us. Like po and share our show and subscribe to our UST Tomashan Alumni Community YouTube channel and Facebook page. The past episodes of Bridges can be watched in our YouTube channel. Pwede nyo pumahanap yun. And of course, thank you for joining us today. Thank you very much. Thank you so much, Dr. Ong. And thank you sa mga nanood. And thank you, Ma'am Vanjie, as my co-host.
Brother Jimmy, can I greet my boss?
Sure, yeah, sure.
Dr. Fernando Pedrosa?
Yes.
Hi, boss Nandi. Sir Nandi, maraming.
Nandi, we wish you all the best of your
life. We wish you, Nandi, sana balik pang ka na. Get out of the hospital. Get back to work.
Next vacation sa hospital. Okay. So, thank you.
Thank you so much. No, thank you so much. Do watch again as on Tuesdays for another exciting episode. So, marami pa pong mga episodes no na ipapalabas ang Bridges. So, please watch. And of course, like and share our pages and our YouTube channel. So, with that, Dr. Vanjie?
Yes. Always remember, here at Bridges, we build bridges of faith, bridges of hope, and bridges of love. Ayan. All together, we say, God bless us all.
Mabuhay.
And mabuhay. Ayan.
Thank you. Thank you, Brad.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Ong.
Thank you.